ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Ooh, fresh out the bed. Ooh, count out the dead. Fresh out. All right, what is up, Utes fans? This is Joseph back with the Utah Utes Football Digest. Larry, I saw your comments. Welcome back, man. Welcome back to all you guys. This should be a really fun one for us tonight. I did a real good job kind of prepping for this one, so hopefully everything goes well. And like I said in the title of the video, today we are going to be talking about the top eight all-time Utah Utes running backs. And just to be clear, guys, there's going to be some really good running backs on this list. There's probably going to be some really good running backs that are left off this list that you might have wanted. But definitely some really cool guys to go over. So first, before we dive into the top eight, we're going to do a few honorable mentions. So the first honorable mention is going to be, let me put him up here on the screen. Give me a second. First honorable mention is going to be a guy that had potential, like Larry just said in the chat, had potential to be one of the greatest running backs ever for Utah. But sadly, his life was cut short. So Ty Jordan, honorable mention, you know, just a kid that had honestly, that one season is up there with almost any one season for Utah. And when we're talking about a per touch average, Ty Jordan was just special. 723 scrimmage yards in five games. That's almost 150 scrimmage yards a game. 7.7 yards per touch. So that means every time you give him the ball on a dump off, on a run, he's getting 7.7 yards. I mean, we're almost talking about a first down every time you gave this guy the ball. But either way, you know, a kid that had a lot of potential that, you know, RIP, very sad to hear, you know, Ty passed. But, you know, a kid definitely will go down in the history of Utah as one of the best five-game stretches. Or, you know, technically it was a season, but not how most seasons work. If that had been a full season of him doing that instead of just a five-game stretch, I don't see why he wouldn't be in the talks in the top eight. I would imagine he would be in the top eight, just to be clear. You guys can see my dog back there behind me here. Larry says, retire number 22 and Wazoo playing at Rice Eccles, bad mojo. Well, yeah, I do believe they did retire number 22. All right, so the next guy that we're going to talk about for honorable mention. So we're not in the top eight yet, guys. Just remember that. The next guy we're going to talk about is going to be Tony Lindsay. Tony Lindsay, definitely a good running back for Utah. Honestly, if you guys know about Utah's history of football, you know that there's some great running backs. And before I dive a little more into Tony Lindsay, you guys that are already in here, make sure you like the video. You know, it's going to be a ton of talent on this list, guys. Make sure you like the video. Let's get it out to other Utes fans. Let's weigh in our opinions. Jump into the chat. If you're not subscribed already, make sure you do. But basically, Tony Lindsay, four seasons for the Utes, 3,342 total scrimmage yards. The guy had 20 total touchdowns. It's kind of what bumped him into the honorable mention category. 20 total touchdowns, as much as, you know, really good player. That's really only five touchdowns a season average on four seasons. So you'd want a little more. And 4.8 yards a touch, which isn't terrible. But we're talking about a top eight list here, guys, of all-time Utes running backs, which is a team that historically has ran the football very well. Number three all-time rushing yards leader. So this was a tough one. So Tony Lindsay was the number three career rushing yards leader for Utah. So it was definitely a tough one to leave him off the list. But in the end, I didn't feel right putting him on the list, just based on some of the other numbers for him. So that's that with Tony. And then the next guy that's going to be an honorable mention is going to be Juan Johnson. Juan Johnson, four seasons for the Utes, 2,768 scrimmage yards, 4.6 yards per touch. Remember, when we say per touch, that's pass, that's receptions, that's run plays. You know, it's a variety of plays. However they get the ball, every time you touch the ball, what you're doing with it. 24 total touchdowns in his career, so about six touchdowns a season. Tied for eighth all-time rushing touchdowns, and tied and is seventh in total rushing yards in his career. So, you know, Juan Johnson's definitely another hitter. Like I said, tied for eighth all-time rushing touchdowns and number seven in total rushing yards. So just to be clear, guys, you can start to tell we're leaving some hitters off the list here. These are not like the honorable mention list for quarterbacks was like, eh. This honorable mention list is bangers. I mean, these guys are beasts. All right. And now the final honorable mention, this is going to be the last honorable mention before we start to dive into, you know, some of the Utah players that actually made the top eight list. It's going to be a guy named Mike Anderson. He played two seasons for Utah, 2,201 scrimmage yards in those two seasons, 5.0 yards per touch. So every time he touched the ball, he's getting 5 yards for the squad, 24 total touchdowns. Tied for eighth in career rushing touchdowns and 10th in total career rushing yards, and also number two in the single game rushing yards category. So he has the second biggest rushing yard game in Utah history. And definitely some big numbers for Mike Anderson. Mike Anderson was probably – Mike Anderson and Tony Lindsay really almost made the list. They were really close. I just felt I just felt like Mike Anderson wasn't quite there to be on the list. And now we can start to talk about the big list, guys. If you really want to hear the list, I would really appreciate it if you guys drop in the chat who you think your top eight is. Looks like David dropped it right here. No particular order, but Jordan, Thomas, Booker, Moss, White, Williams, White, a double white, a double dipper on the white, David. I love your wedding picture there, man. Looks like a great time. Before we dive into the list, make sure you guys like the video so we can get it out to more Utes fans. This should be a fun one. I think you guys are going to like what we're going to do in a minute here. And I think there's going to be one or two names in this top eight that you guys might not be expecting to be in there. So let's go ahead and dive in to the top eight list. David, I noticed that you've had Jordan on your little comment here. Just so you guys know, I already mentioned Ty Jordan. Monster did not make the top eight list just because as much as it was technically a season, it was only a five-game stretch. It was an amazing five-game stretch, but it's not enough of a sample size to put him in the top eight, but definitely honorable mention, definitely top 12 all time for sure. If this was a top 10 list, Ty Jordan would absolutely be in the conversation. So now let's go ahead and talk about the first running back on this list, guys. This is a bit of a throwback for you. His name is – I like to build the tension, guys, so give me a second here. All right, so number eight, the first guy to actually make the top eight Utah Utes running back list. Let's put him on the screen here. Chris Fuamatu Maafala. So this guy, I believe it was in the 80s. You guys can double check it for me if you want. And I decided to go, you know, a little more fun for you guys this time. Let's throw some video up. So this is Chris Fuamatu Maafala, just a hammer of a man. This guy played three seasons for the Utes, also played for the Steelers in the NFL. Three seasons, 2,755 total scrimmage yards, 23 total touchdowns. This guy put up 5.8 yards every single time he touched the ball. So think about that, guys. This guy had three seasons with almost an average of 1,000 scrimmage yards, and every time he touched the ball, he's getting 5.8 yards a touch. I mean, that's pretty damn impressive if you ask me. He is the number five career rushing yards leader, or not leader, but number five in total career rushing yards, and is tied for number eight in total career rushing touchdowns, has the number four single game rushing yards record. So that was Chris Fuamatu Maafala. I don't know if you guys remember him. Let's see, someone commented. Let's see, what's this one? Leather helmet list coming up. No, Larry, I'd say there's one more, maybe. Maybe one more, maybe two more that'll be a bit of a throwback. But outside of that, Larry, this is going to be a lot of modern players. I mean, you guys, a bunch of you guys have already mentioned some of the guys in the chat. We've, the past 10, 12 years, there have been some big-time running backs to come out of Utah. So on that note, let's go ahead and dive into the next guy. So the next guy, his name is Del Rogers. This won't be a guy we have a video for. He is a bit of a throwback, but definitely a big-time player for Utah. So let me get him up here. Sorry about this, guys. All right. All right, so Del Rogers out of Utah. He played four seasons for the Utes, 2,954. Here, let me put this up on the screen, guys. Give me 1 second. Number seven, Del Rogers. Okay. All right, I'm about to share the screen with the stats for you guys. Some of these older guys, it was tough to find video on them, but, you know, their numbers are hard to say they don't make this list, right? And he's not like, you know, these guys are 80s, so it's not like they're, this, I guess, late 70s, early 80s. So Del Rogers is when we were in the WAC. But you check this out, guys, a few solid seasons. Total over the four seasons, he's got 2,954 scrimmage yards, averaged 5.6 yards per touch. Honestly, with that 5.6 yards per touch on 3,000 scrimmage yards, it was arguable that he should have been maybe even a little higher, right? I mean, that's very impressive numbers. 32 total touchdowns, so we're looking at 8 touchdowns a year. And that first year, he's not really getting a lot of play time, right? 45 plays, so not really making an impact. So almost, you know, we're talking about basically 10 yards or 10 touchdowns a season for the next 3 years. So definitely Del Rogers, a beast for Utah. The guy that, you know, really put the team on his back for those few years. But, yeah, definitely more of a throwback there. Not leather helmet, like Larry said, but a guy's definitely a throwback. but here with that, guys, let's go ahead and move on to number six. So number six should be one that's a little more modern. I should have a video for him here, and I think you guys will know this guy. Some of you maybe even would think this guy would be higher. Maybe some won't feel the same. This is a guy that had one huge year. He had one huge year, but that one huge year, he had 2 years, but the first year he wasn't the main guy. I'm sure you guys might already know who I'm talking about with the hints. A more modern guy. I see a comment. Let's see. I don't know why I can't see the comments right now. So I guess I'll see them as they come up. But if you guys do know who I'm talking about, let's go ahead and throw them on the screen. We're talking about Joe Williams. So Joe Williams, just a beast. Let's put up the tape. Tell you guys a little bit about Joe Williams. Two seasons for the Utes. The guy had 2,075 total scrimmage yards. Over 1,500 of those coming in one season. Just a monster. Why Joe Williams isn't higher on this list? Only 13 total touchdowns. Sorry about the grainy video here. It just uploaded that way. But with that, so 13 total touchdowns. You know, and that is way less touchdowns than a lot of the other guys. The reason he got here, he's not lower, he's not higher. He's not higher because of the 13 total touchdowns. The reason he is here and not lower is number one in single game rushing yards. You know, killed it. I believe it was against UCLA, just murdered him. Also, 6.2 yards per touch. So every time he got the ball, he was getting 6.2 yards. I mean, that's nuts. That's a crazy number. 6.2 yards. It's just really high. It's really tough to stop a guy that's getting 6.2 yards per touch. With that, also, he had the number 5 single season rushing yards. So total seasons ever in Utah history, he had the number 5 single season rushing yards. So definitely a monster there. And just to recap with you guys who we've gone over so far. So honorable mentions, we had Ty Jordan. We had Juan Johnson, Tony Lindsey, Mike Anderson. All those were honorable mentions. And then for the top 8, we had Chris Fuamatu Maafala. We had Del Rogers at number 7. And we had Joe Williams at number 6. And if you guys know how damn good Joe Williams was, you should boom. David says you got to go, but love the stuff to fill in the offseason. Hey, I'm glad you like it, David. We'll keep it going into the regular season, too. Larry says Joe Williams' UCLA game was insane, like 323 that game. Yeah, I believe it was something like that. So, yeah, definitely just a crazy game. Put the team on his back. Just went nuts, right? Now let's go ahead and dive into the number 5 running back in Utah football history. All right, and here he is, Tavion Thomas. Tavion Thomas, if you're a Utah fan, I can't imagine you not knowing who this kid is. Just a freaking hammer. The whole highlight reel is touchdowns. Yes, it is one season, but it rushing-wise, if you guys don't already know, I mean, Tavion Thomas, one season, 1,111 total yards from scrimmage, 5.4 yards every single time he touched the ball. So 5.4 yards per touch, 21 total touchdowns rushing. Just the, you know, those are monster numbers. He holds the single season all-time rushing touchdowns in a single season leader. You know, Tavion is just a beast, a monster among men. There's part of me that wants him higher on this list. The other part of me thinks this might even be a little high for him. This is just kind of where I wound up with it. And all in all, I think Tavion's probably up there with one of the best running backs we've ever had. Larry broke the TD record. Yep, just like we talked about. But more than anything, Tavion, if he can follow last season up with even something in the realm of what he did, right? I mean, he could have 5 less touchdowns and still have be just behind his record. So that was Tavion Thomas. You know, he's a monster, one of the best running backs that's ever played for Utah. Thing is, right now it's just a one game stretch, so we got to see kind of how he does ongoing. If he could follow it up with another banger year, I'm sure he moves up a few spots on this list. So that's Tavion Thomas. You guys know who he is, a monster. The next guy we are going to be looking at is going to be, let me put him up here. We got a video for him too. This is a fun one. Let's get him going. All right. All right, so the number 4 running back in Utah football history is John the Wolfman White. And if you guys know anything about John White, just a very fast, elusive runner. Again, sorry about the grainy video. I don't know why it's coming up that way. But just, you know, a real mean runner, a guy that was tough to bring down, very fast, very elusive. Some of the numbers about John White, 2 seasons, that's it. 2,727 scrimmage yards with 26 total touchdowns. So we're talking about basically almost 1,400 yards average from scrimmage in 2 seasons, 26 touchdowns, is 13 touchdowns a season, tied for number 5 all-time rushing touchdowns, and is number 8 for all-time rushing yards for Utah, and did it in just 2 seasons. So crazy, crazy numbers, right? He's also tied for 2nd best rushing touchdowns in a single season, and the number 1 best single rushing season all-time. So definitely, you know, there's a reason they call him the Wolfman, just a monster. Larry says one Moss, two Booker, three Asiata. Well, we will see, Larry. You might be a little disappointed about one of those, but we'll see. But yeah, so John White, just a monster, right? Now let's go ahead and move into number three. Number three, you know, a little bit of a throwback, nothing too crazy, but definitely a little bit of a throwback here. Don't have a video for this one, but not crazy old, but a guy that I think you guys will appreciate the numbers and kind of why I really had no option but to put this guy here. I mean, I felt like, you know, debatedly there I could put other guys here, but I just didn't feel right. Preston says he loved White in bowl game against Georgia Tech. Yeah, White was a monster, right? Tiny little guy, but just a monster. So now let's go ahead and move on to number three. And that is going to be Eddie Johnson. So Eddie Johnson was the Utes running back. Let me pull up the years. You guys know I do some digging before we make these videos. That's why I'm kind of exhausting, but I do some digging. So check him out here. So from 1984 to 1988, five seasons as the Utes lead man, 4,058 total scrimmage yards, 6.2 yards every time he touched the ball, and 35 total touchdowns over his career. Obviously, he had the one down season here in in 1987. But outside of that, not a great season at 503 in 85. But outside of that, just killing it. And in 87, he's at 7.3 yards per touch. So I'm guessing the real story is something along the lines of, you know, he got injured or something. We'd have to look more into it, though. Yeah, so definitely a beast. Now we're going to move into the top two. Just to recap, before we get into the top two Utah running backs all time. So, Larry, I'm sure you noticed from your comment earlier that someone will be left off that list. Just to break it back down for you, who we've done so far, honorable mentions, we had Ty Jordan. We had Tony Lindsay. We had Juan Johnson, Mike Anderson. Then the top eight, Chris Fuamatu Maafala. Seven, Del Rogers. Six, Joe Williams. Five, Tavion Thomas. Four, John White. Number three, Eddie Johnson. And now we move into the top two. So these guys are both pretty recent guys, right? As we move into it, let's see. Well, I just told you, I guess this is your top five then, CA. Cool. So now let's go ahead and move into the number two running back for Utah all time. Definitely a fan favorite. Definitely a guy. I can't imagine you guys having too much disagreement with me here, but it sounds like a few of you guys think someone's going to be on here that's not. I mean, I'm sure you guys are starting to pick around and realize one of the guys you guys think is going to be on here won't be on here. So number two all time is Devontae Booker. Devontae Booker, just an animal, guys. I mean, yeah, obviously one of the best, right? He's the number two running back all time. Two seasons for Utah, 3,395 total scrimmage yards in those two seasons. I mean, that's ridiculous. I mean, we're talking about 1,700 scrimmage yards a season in a two-season stretch. 23 touchdowns in those 2 years. 5.3 yards every single time this guy touched the ball. And on that type of scrimmage yards, 5.3 is just as impressive as six. Number four all-time rushing yards leader. Think about that, guys. He's the number four all-time rushing yards leader, and he only played 2 years. I mean, that's just wild, right? You're able to put up those types of numbers in 2 years. And then number two all-time single rushing season in Utah history. The guy's just an animal. You can see by the tape, he's a special player. He is incredibly difficult to get to the ground, incredibly explosive when he gets in open space. a mean runner. And there's a reason this guy is the number two running back all time. I think in one of these highlights, you even see Britton Covey, pretty sure. But really cool. So Devontae Booker, just an animal and a guy that, you know, big time fan of his, the way he runs the ball, the way he plays the game, the meanness, the toughness, the explosiveness, the athleticism. I mean, there's not much more you could ask for. And that's why there's only one guy that is going to be above him. And I'm guessing you guys know who the number one is. At least I'm hoping, right? The number one is a very, very special player for Utah, right? He's kind of a one-of-a-kind guy. Let's go ahead and drop him in. I would have you guys guess at who you think it is, but honestly, I'm of the opinion that's got to be somewhat obvious, right? Camden C says, just in time for one. Well, I knew, honestly, guys, I backed up the stats to confirm it. My cat and my dog are fighting back here. Get out of here. All right, but I backed up the stats to confirm it before I made the call. But honestly, I knew who number one was right when I started, right? Larry says he made the top eight for me. Yeah, and, you know, looking back, Asiati probably should have been an honorable mention, but he is not the number one. You guys know who it is. Come on, let's not play around. It's Zach Moss. Zach Moss, the eye test, the ability on the field, the tenacity, the competitive spirit, just all around the best running back in Utah history. And it's quite a list we've got here, guys. This isn't just, you know, some random group of guys that we threw together. 4 seasons for Utah. Zach Moss had 4,752 total scrimmage yards, 41 total touchdowns in 4 seasons. So even including a freshman season where he only got a couple hundred yards, he still averaged over 10 touchdowns a year. 6.1 yards every time Zach Moss touched the ball. And the number one all-time rushing yards leader for Utah. Like I said, guys, the kid's a beast. I mean, let's not act like it was really, for me, and I don't know if you guys feel the same, for me, it really wasn't that much of a competition. Larry said, LOL, Moss, without a doubt. I'm guessing you said that after I said, I told you Asiati wasn't the guy. Yeah, those throwback uniforms are nice, right? That's and honestly, it's really cool to watch Zach Moss. And just so you guys know, Zach Moss is the number one rushing yards in his career, number one rushing touchdowns in a career. I mean, just a monster, guys. Number tied for number two rushing touchdowns in a single season, number four rushing yards in a single season, and an all-purpose guy, right? That rushing yards in a single season is 1,400, and there's about another 400 yards of receiving work from Zach Moss that year. So just a guy that's a beast, right? If you guys enjoy these lists, Jeremy says Glover's next. Yeah, I mean, hopefully, man. I would love to see it. I think Tavion Thomas is more where I'm focused on, and I want to see him move up a few spots on this list. I really think he will. But hopefully Glover, you know, makes his name too. I mean, Tavion doesn't need to do that much to move up a lot on this list. But on that note, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you guys like it if you're enjoying the content. Yeah, Larry, I thought about adding that in. I tried to make this one just about the running backs, but definitely I thought about the scrapping of divisions. I keep up to date with the stuff. So I definitely considered that. But if you guys enjoyed this, like the video. I always appreciate it. It gets it out to more Utes fans. And it lets me know that you guys enjoy these top 8, top 5 videos that I'm making. I mean, a lot of work does go into this. I know some of these might just seem obvious, but I'm a numbers guy. I do a lot of research before I make these decisions. And that's probably why you see some leather helmets, like Larry said, on these lists, because I want to make sure that they're accurate. If you guys agreed with the list, make sure you comment in the chat that you like the list. If you guys have your own top 8 list, feel free to drop that in the chat as well. I would love to hear what your list is. And if you guys haven't already, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. This is going to be such a fun year, guys. this should be a big time breakout year. And we're going to be just pumping out these videos all season, pregame, postgame, middle of the week, updates on where our guys are nationally compared to other players at their position. Should be a lot of fun, guys. Larry also digging some recruits who have listed Utah. Go Utes. Appreciate you, buddy. Thanks, Larry. Larry is a great guy. That's always coming on this page. Gotta love him. Larry, I appreciate all your comments, man. We should do a guess who will be the new star in the Utes in 2022. Yeah, absolutely. I would love to know who's going to be the new star of the Utes in 2022. But on that note, guys, I am going to close this out. I have had a draining week. You know, I basically got home and spent 2 hours, 3 hours getting all the research done for this video, getting these little video clips done. So I hope you guys appreciate these. And I look forward to continuing to make them for you guys. If you guys don't know already, CA, great show. Thank you very much, man. I appreciate it. Next Friday, 8 o'clock Mountain Standard Time. I will be here. I will see you guys here. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Stay safe. Larry, peace. Rest up. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. All right. Bye, guys. Go Utes.